As the song goes,
you must remember this, a kiss is just a kiss.
Unless, of course, it's between two men, that is. Then, it's nowhere to be seen. Wait, there it is.
Okay, that is not entirely true. There is men kissing men on TV somewhere all the time, but it is treated very differently to straight kissing.
For instance, Will and Grace, a show where most of the male characters are gay, featured Deborah Messing taking a different dude to the Bone Zone each week, but its first man-on-man kiss ended up 36 episodes in. And even then, it wasn't even romantic. It was just between two friends.
Not cool! Totally lame!
Modern Family faced criticism in its first season for not really being all that modern. After 22 episodes of all the other couples constantly shoving tongues down each other's throats, it looked like it was Cam and Mitchell's turn. But no.
Hi, honey.
Yay! Gay hug right next to all the straight people kisses.
I am so sorry.
It was my fault.
No, Mitchell, it is not your fault. It is Hollywood's fault. The two eventually did kiss on camera 4 episodes later in an episode called The Kiss. And it was very anticlimactic, especially considering that the episode was written in direct response to online petitions saying the two should be more affectionate. They even wrote it into the plot that Mitchell had an aversion to public displays of affection.
Which is a genius way of passing the buck and pretending like it's a storyline. Although why they couldn't have kissed in the privacy of their own home for the previous 25 episodes, I have no idea. Shh, don't ask questions.
Obviously, there are actual shows featuring lots of dude-on-dude macking.
I watch The L Word, okay?
Good.
I watch Queer as F.
That's not what it's called.
Queer as Folk, Looking, 6 Feet Under, and Please Like Me are all great examples. But at the same time, they're all cable shows or digital channel shows. The big main networks still seem quite afraid of making people uncomfortable.
Why do I have to see homosexual men kissing on TV shows now? We get it. You're here. You're queer. Congratulations. Not everyone's a flamboyant homosexual, you know. I'm sticking to Netflix.
Gee, I wonder what he thinks about lesbians.
They're hot.
The worst part? He's not alone.
All the way back in 2011, a British survey company, YouGov, reported that 11% of people are prudish virgins who don't think there should ever be any kissing on TV. 89% think that it's acceptable for straight couples to kiss on TV. 83% of people were alright with lesbian kisses.
They're hot!
But only 76% of people thought it was okay to have man smooches on TV.
Look, no one is suggesting that this is the most important issue in the LGBTI community. It's TV drama. All we're saying is networks, harden the f*** up. I do. I want you to
show me. And that is our producer Chris, who, in case you're curious, does taste like HPV. We are joined by comedian and noted gay man around the village, Rhys Nicholson. Welcome to the feed.
Thanks for having me.
And film and TV writer Maria Lewis. Welcome back to the feed.
That was beautiful. I loved that. That was fantastic.
I'm just going to barrel straight forward.
Yeah, sure.
Do you think there is, Rhys, a problem with television not having enough gay men kissing on?
Look, I mean, I think there is, although now having watched that clip, I think maybe there's too much now. We have too much. The segment's over. Too much men kissing. I think there is. I think there's the right amount, but it's the tone of it. I'm already getting very serious. But there's never just like, oh, we're just going to kiss, or we're a couple and we're just kissing. It's always like, cut, or a peck. Like, there's never just kind of couples kissing.
But there are those shows, like we mentioned earlier, Looking and 6 Feet Under, that did show that. But I guess the issue, Maria, is that they're not necessarily in the mainstream. It's quite a limited view of gayness.
Yeah, they're kind of, like, there's shows definitely where there's, like, it's not saying there's not gays on television, because you have shows like L Word or Queer as Folk, but they, and Looking as well, but they're classified as, like, the gay show. What we need to see is, I guess, more just, like, general integration into a normal everyday show, because there's a normal everyday part of life.
Are there places where you think it shouldn't happen, where actually it doesn't have a place in television?
Hell no. I think recently what we've seen fantastically is it spread to children's television in a really tasteful, like, appropriate way with Legend of Korra, which just finished on its 4th season with the main character going off with a woman and her actually essentially coming out as a lesbian, which is really great. And it's not done in an overt way. It's just that there needs to be representation so young gay kids growing up can actually see themselves on television. So they're not like, it's not taboo. It's considered a completely normal and natural thing, which it is.
Television is such a populous medium. And we're particularly talking here about network television. If so many of the actual population are fine with it, why is it television networks having so much trouble keeping up?
Oh, I don't know.
The hand up was my favourite part of that.
I think it's because so much of Hollywood in general is still in the closet. It is a place that's largely run by heterosexual white males. There is a lot of people in Hollywood who are actually gay, but they're forced into the closet because it's considered not marketable, it's not profitable to be an openly gay actor. You have people like Neil Patrick Harris and Matt Bomer who are out, and Ian McKellen, God bless him, he's amazing. But that's it. That's like enough to count on one hand. You don't have enough actors out there like that. Whereas everybody's heard, you know, gay rumors about a particular actor, or there's been explicit like sex videos about a particular actor, but they're not actually out of the closet because it's considered to ruin their brand.
And there's still that thing of every time a straight actor plays a gay character, it's like Oscar buzz. Ooh.
Yeah, this is true.
But Neil Patrick Harris played a straight dude in Gone Girl, and people were like, yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, that's such a good point, because if a straight guy plays a gay guy, it's like, oh, Brokeback, here's an Oscar. But if a gay guy plays a straight guy, yeah, exactly.
The hand spitting.
Yeah, hand spitting. That's what
that
was.
Let's talk about that. I don't know if I'm going to quit you. But if a gay guy plays a straight guy, it's just like, oh, well, you know, that's what they have to do in everyday life, or that's what they've had to do growing up, is pay a straight guy, so why do they deserve any extra recognition?
Maria Lewis, Rhys Nicholson, thanks for joining us here on The Feed.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
Hey, tomorrow on the show, we are talking to Christine Forster, who many people will know. She is the sister of Tony Abbott. She's going to be talking about her relationship, her brother, and marriage equality. That's tomorrow on The Feed.